Hey, Cleaning Nation, ever listen to the show and think, if I could just get this guy to help me out, I would save so much time and frustration? Or my life would be awesome if I could just get a few of these systems they're actually talking about actually implemented into my business? Well, if that's you, I've got some spectacular news. I am hosting our first ever live event. We are personally going to walk through the Clean Profit Method with no more than 16 owners of cleaning companies in just 2.5 days. I cannot wait to get to know you and your business personally and implement the entire Clean Profit Method together. If this is scratching where you itch, stop watching or listening to the show right now and go to growmycleaningcompany.com/live to get all the details. Like I said, I can't wait to get to know you and your business personally and implement the entire Clean Profit Method. growmycleaningcompany.com/live. Check it out now. I'll see you soon. Cleaning Nation, welcome to another episode of the Grow My Cleaning Company podcast. As always, we start the show by fill in the blank. You guys can say it with me, telling you that you are amazing. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all the subscribing, rating, reviews on iTunes. We've got 100 or something, but all the positive reviews really make a difference for us. Same with YouTube. Feel free to subscribe, comment, engage, join the Grow My Cleaning Company group on Facebook. Tons of free stuff. The reason we exist and do what we do is because you are amazing human beings. That said, today we are chatting with my new best friend, Robbie Johnson. She just started Metro Building Services in Nashville, Tennessee, and we're going to see if we can't help her out today. Robbie, welcome to the show.
Oh, thank you so much. I appreciate you having me.
I am glad to have you. Robbie, tell me a little bit about your story. How'd you get in the cleaning business? Is this full-time, part-time? Do you have any clients yet? Good Lord, my voice just jumped away. What's going on in your world?
Well, I just started Metro Building Services, so I'm brand new. I've had one, I actually did do a carpet at one bank, so that's only been my only service so far, so I'm just getting started.
All right, well, those are some of my favorite clients, because we work with these big companies that are millions of dollars, and a lot of it is like, all right, go back to the beginning, start from this. What are your core values? We just have to go all the way back, and I don't want to say undo, but it's the difference between teaching someone that's never played golf and doesn't have any bad habits and someone that's played golf and has a bunch of terrible habits that you got to fix before you can go forward. I love working with people that are brand new and just ready to roll. So what's going on? How can I help you specifically today?
Well, I'm trying to find my niche, so I thought I would start with a bank. I did hear your podcast where you say, you know, try to get into a niche market, so I want to start there and try it out.
First of all, I love that you're not just, you know, tens of thousands of people, hundreds of thousands of people listen to the podcast, but the percentage to actually do something and take advantage of the advice and the feedback is much smaller. So congratulations on just starting out and saying, I'm going to pick a niche. It's going to be banks. Banks is a great niche. So A, you're in the right, just by doing that, you're in the right spot. All right. The first and foremost thing is most people want to talk about them and their company as opposed to the customer and their pain. That works in your favor. If you're going up with a much larger company that's doing millions of dollars in revenue, got tons of employees, tons of experience, you don't want to be talking about yourself in that light, because you're gonna lose out. The good news is your customer couldn't care less about that. All they care about is, do you understand their pain, or actually can you solve their pain? And the way they decide if you can solve their pain or not is by you demonstrating how well you understand it. Believe it or not, just by explaining to people how empathizing with them and letting them know you understand where they're at and how they feel, they will automatically assume that you can solve that pain for them. It's a weird thing. Just like if you go to the, I think I've used this example before, and I think I stole it from a guy named Russ Ruffino. He talks about if you're walking down the road with a world famous arm doctor, shoulder doctor, and he charges $1,000 an hour, and you're talking to him, and a hobo walks up here overhearing the conversation, says, "Oh, you've got that pain that starts at your shoulder and goes all the way down to your elbow, and when you bend it, it goes right back up, and it feels like a stinging, biting pain, and if it's raining, it feels even worse." You go, "Oh my!" You will immediately ignore the world famous doctor, and all of your attention will be on the hobo that knows nothing. It's just, you know, doesn't know anything about you. You go, "Oh my gosh, you understand my pain," and you're going to ask him, "What did you do to solve that?" Right? So
exactly,
if a hobo can get your attention over a world famous doctor, I promise you, Robbie, the brand new owner of a cleaning company, can get a bank's attention over some other cleaning company that's been doing it for years. And the good thing is, I shouldn't say I promise you, but I would highly doubt unless I've got one of my clients out there, even then it wouldn't be banks, that there is another cleaning company in Nashville that focuses on banks. So if I'm like, hey, Mr. Bank customer, I'm big and bad and I've got car dealerships and this and that, and I'm the, you know, we've got a million employees and we're the best things since sliced bread, good. And when you say, you know, hey, Mr. Bank teller, owner, manager, all we do is banks. I don't take anyone that's not a bank. All I do is banks. I've forgotten more about what makes you guys tick than everybody else knows. That's very compelling, right? I'm half an idiot, and I do really well helping owners of cleaning companies because this is all I help, right? I've had bunches of other businesses, but I get so many people go, oh, I had other coaches, but they couldn't really help. They didn't understand where I was at. I love that you owned a cleaning business and that you only help owners of cleaning business, and you get who we are and what's going on. Hey, Cleaning Nation, are you enjoying the show? Want to go from listening to doing? If you're committed to making this the year that you kick your company into hypergrowth and actually start implementing all the systems that I coach on this show that will allow you to work on your business instead of in it, go to growmycleaningcompany.com/live to get all the details on our upcoming live event. I'm going to personally walk you and 15 other entrepreneurs through the entire Clean Profit method in just 2.5 days. growmycleaningcompany.com/live. Check it out now. I'll see you soon. So the same reason you're probably attracted to this show is, hey, I want to own a cleaning company. I'm going to listen to this knucklehead as opposed to the 1,000 other knuckleheads out there, is the same reason we can have banks be attracted to you, because you're going to be the bank specialist. So like, even if that's going to be your niche, I'd call your name Metro Bank Building. So I wouldn't even call it Metro. I'd call Nashville Bank Building Services, right? If that's going to be our niche, by golly, let's start that way. And later you can change it okay. To, you know, whatever bank building services. But again, the name of this podcast isn't Mike's a Genius, Everyone Shut Up and Listen. Although that was the first idea, and somehow it didn't make it through. It's Grow My Cleaning Company, right? So you know right away, do I have a cleaning company or want a cleaning company? Yes. Do I want to grow it? I'm in the right spot, right? If it's Mike Talks Business, you know, who's interested in that? Ask my wife, nobody. So first and foremost, the niche is a big thing. Second, we're not going to go to sell anything, right? People don't like being sold, but they love to buy stuff. So what I'm going to encourage you to do is get their pain. I'm also going to encourage you to go, especially if you're starting out, get into the Clean Profit Method. You can go to cleanprofitmethod.com or growmycleaningcompany.com to get all the information. Step three goes over all the stuff that we're going to talk about. How to pick a niche, how to make a guarantee. We can't get into that now. I'd absolutely make a branded guarantee, have a unique selling proposition. All that's in step three. But the piece I want to pull out of there right now is the perfect prospect survey. I think it's 3 or 4 pages, and it's in depth of exactly what to ask these people. So it's difficult to go to a bank, especially if it says no soliciting, stay out, leave us alone, and say, hey, can I tell you about my cleaning company? You can do that, and you ask 100 girls to dance, one of them's going to say yes, but you might get slapped in the face 99 times. Same with a bank. You're going to get a lot of no's and get the heck out and, you know, can I help you, homeless person? But if you go in and say, can I ask you some questions? I'm starting a cleaning company that just serves banks. I just want to know what upsets you, what makes you happy, you know, how I could make your life better. Would you be willing to give me 5 or 10 minutes to answer some questions? Now, you're not going to get 100% yeses on that either, but I promise you ask 100 banks that question, you'll probably get 30 or 40 yeses and 20 or 30. Oh, no, I'm busy, but that's a good idea. Let me know what comes up of it. Whereas if you ask 100 banks, can I give you a bid? You might get one, right? So don't ask for the bid. Ask them for information. Try and understand their pain better than anybody else. Like, I know your guys' pain better than anyone else because I've interviewed nearly 300 of you, and then I coach hundreds of people. So, you know, I know more about the pain of owners of cleaning companies than anybody walking the face of this earth. You, in a very short amount of time, can know more about the pain of either branch managers or property managers, or that's something you'll have to learn about your niche in Nashville. Who is the one that makes that decision? And you can know more about those people and what they go through than anyone else in Nashville, than anyone else in the face of the world. Does that make sense? Wow.
That makes a lot of sense. That's a great idea. Thank you.
So that's what I would do. I wouldn't, the first sale, and I'm doing huge air quotes with sale, I would look for is, yes, you can ask me, you can come down here and bring some donuts for the team, and I'm happy to give you 10 minutes to answer your questions. If you can pull off 5 or 10 of those in person, and again, you can email people and do an online survey, not as good. Right. It would be different if we did a podcast where instead of talking to real human beings and trying to help them, you just email me a question and then I just like read an answer on. It's not the same, right? We get to talk and you get to go, hold on, that's not what I mean, and tell me about this, and I'm scared, and I can really understand who you are as opposed to just email. So yes, you can do this via email. You can do a survey like online, get all technical. I like eyeball to eyeball, belly to belly. Hopefully bring some donuts or something. That's the best way. If you can pull off 10 of those, I can just about guarantee you 3 of them will ask you to bid. Because again, you're like, hey, tell me about this, tell me about that. 2 or 3 are going to go, well, shoot, I've got a cleaning company. I can barely get to show up. None of them ask me any questions like this about what I would have to do to make my life easier. I can't even get them to pick up dead cockroaches in the corner. Why don't you just why won't you just give me a bid? And that's fantastic. Now you don't have to sell anything. They're buying, right? People hate to be sold, but they love to buy. So if you just go and ask a bunch of questions and really try to add value to their lives, you'd be shocked at how many people respond to that and go, well, you've already given me more value than my cleaning company. Why don't you guys just give me a bid? And then, so that's probably how you get your first sale is you do, you know, I would shoot for 10 of these perfect prospect surveys, and you can make your own or join Clean Profit Method and get access to the one I've created for you. I bet you that'd be your first or second sale. And then once you do make it, the 7 or 8 or 9 people that don't ask you to bid, you go back and go, hey, I found it. Would you be interested in the results of what branch managers or whoever that person is in the bank? Would you be interested in what I found out in terms of what their pain is? Most of the time they're going to say yes. You go, and I created a solution for your pain, right? So when I first started with a Grow My Cleaning Company, I asked all of you guys what your pain is, and I found out you have 2. How do I get customers and how do I get employees? Good customers at good prices and employees that don't quit in the middle of the night. So I can go back to you if I want to sell you something, go, hey, Robbie, would you like to give me money if I can tell you how to get customers? And most likely you're going to go, oh my gosh, how did you know? That's exactly what I need. Right. And it works great. So that is the end of my rant. I would, first and foremost, great job on picking a niche. Second of all, get pain first. Third of all, give value for free in advance. Just by asking them these questions and really listening, you're going to be giving value. You can take it another level by bringing donuts. You can take it another level by having an event, a lunch and learn just for banks. You can offer free downloads, free cheat sheets, an information product that solves some of the needs that they have that you give away for free. I do that via this podcast, right? Instead of knocking on your door and, hey, Robbie, I know how to grow your cleaning company. Give me some money. I could do that 100 times and maybe somebody would say yes. But instead of just this podcast, I coach a bunch of people for free and I have more people coming to me than I can even help saying, hey, please help me. So find a way to give value in advance, right? I don't charge anything for this podcast, but I have tens of thousands of people that know, like, and trust me, very easy to sell. So your goal for the next couple months is just to get dozens of banks to know, like, and trust you, give them a bunch of value, and you won't have to sell anything. They will come to you asking for your help. All right, rant over. Any questions, feedback, needs, follow-up, anything else you need before we hit the lightning round?
Well, I think you gave me some really great ideas that I'm going to follow up on. This is a great start for me.
That's the magic. I have 0 clients of mine that do what we talk about doing and don't succeed. 100% success rate with the people that do it. The problem is people that listen and don't do. So as good as that advice is, if you don't take any of it, it will make you exactly $0. But I promise you, if you go face to face, eyeball to eyeball, with 10 people and ask them, really listen to them, you'll get at least one. You'll get at least your first sale. So I'll even make you a deal. You come back in 60 days, right, however long it takes, after you've done at least 10 of these face to face, and I will donate $100 to the charity of your choice if you don't have at least one customer. The only rules being, wow, you gotta go face to face. You got to ask these questions and you have to listen. You can't just be like, what's your pain? Okay, got it. What would you like? Okay, got it. Okay, you got to really ask it important questions and you got to really listen. Go tell me about that. How does that make you feel? Why do you feel that way? What would need to happen for you to feel better about that? I guarantee you, and like I said, $100 a charity of your choice. If you come back and look me in the virtual eyes and tell me I talked to 10 people, not one of them asked me for a bid, I will absolutely donate. But I'd rather have you on and go, oh my gosh, 3 people asked me for a bid. I got my first 1 or 2 clients and I talked to the other people and things are going great. Either way, you feel free to come back. All right. If you have no more feedback, let's hit the lightning round. I'm going to shut up for 2 darn seconds and give you the opportunity to share some of your genius, even as a brand new owner, with a couple questions. Question number 1, what's the best piece of advice you've ever received, either personal or professional?
I believe pretty much don't reinvent the wheel.
Okay, how do you mean?
And I think that's pretty much what I'm trying to do now. Kind of get information that's, been used before and just go ahead and use it.
Well, you are off to a good start by saying I didn't just listen that you should have a niche. I created a niche. So that's fantastic. All right. Question number two. What's the biggest mistake you've made in the cleaning business so we can all learn from it?
I
know you're new, so this might be tough.
Well, actually, I named my business Metro Building Services, and then I got feedback that that wasn't really the best name.
Whoever gave you that feedback sounds like a genius to me. You should listen to him. that's good, right? You're still at a point in your business where you can pivot. You're brand new, so mistakes don't have a bunch of zeros after them. That is great feedback, and I'm shocked at how many people have listened to all my podcasts. I'm like, oh, what's the name of your business? They're like, Mike's Cleaning. I'm like, people don't care about Mike. Who's your customer? Talk about them. Talk about your pain. All right, one idea Cleaning Nation could put into practice right away, something easy to implement. Doesn't have to be a big deal, big or small, but something easy to implement that Cleaning Nation could put into practice right as soon as this podcast is over.
Well, everything I got is listening from your podcast and everything. So what I thought was a great idea is when you're training your employees to actually make a video of it, and like a YouTube video, and then you can just have them watch it.
I agree with me. Great advice. couldn't have said it better. I couldn't have said it better because I did say it.
You can tell I've been listening a lot.
I love that you listen, but I'm even more excited about the fact that you're actually implementing, and I cannot wait to hear the follow-up with you doing these perfect prospect surveys and just getting results, because I know with your personality and your just empathy, we arm you with a good tool, and the questions to ask, you are going to have success. Robbie, thank you for joining us. I love your passion and your vibe. I appreciate you. I know Cleaning Nation appreciates you. Cleaning Nation, if you want to get all of the everything you need basically to grow your cleaning company, including the Clean Profit Method, including the Perfect Prospect Guarantee, I mean, everything that everything I've learned over the last 20 years, it's all at growmycleaningcompany.com. Check it out right now. I made a special video for you. You can go get right now for no charge with a bunch of free bonus trainings. It's awesome. growmycleaningcompany.com. Go there right now. Check it out. I'll see you there.
Congratulations. You are now 16% smarter. Still can't get enough cleaning goodness? Go to www.growmycleaningcompany.com for more of the good stuff. Ever want to be rich and famous? Owners of cleaning companies, as well as industry experts, can apply to be featured on the show by emailing our producer, Natalie, at support@growmycleaningcompany.com. Until then, don't miss out on all the latest cleaning industry lovin' at www.growmycleaningcompany.com. Check it out now.